In what world do you not include Johnny Cage in a Mortal Kombat live action movie? That's just totally strange to me, man. Like, I don't understand that. Like, what are we doing? Like, Johnny Cage is one of the most iconic characters in Mortal Kombat. How do you not include him? In any case, so we have our new trailer for Mortal Kombat, which looks alright-ish, I guess. It looks fine. I'll be honest, it looks very much B grade. It looks like something that was supposed to come out in the 90s. I'm kidding, no. There's a lot of like cool like elements to it. There's a lot of like cool fight scenes. There's a lot of like the visual effects like are a bit like on the lower end. Like it kind of looks like After Effects. Looks like a 15-year-old messing around with After Effects. Especially like with the Kano heat vision thing. Like that was just so strange. Like because he's got both eyes. So is that like coming out of like is he like Superman essentially? Like I don't know. Anyhow, it looks very much After Effects. Especially that scene particularly looks very After Effects. The rest of the stuff is passable. Like we could get by with that. Again, like I said, it looks good-ish. It looks okay-ish. But releasing a trailer 2 months before the movie releases, that's definitely a red flag. However, though, I am super excited. It's a Mortal Kombat movie, man. Like we haven't had this for almost like what, like 25 years now, I believe it's 25 years. And we've been waiting for this for the longest time. So I am excited. I really want to see what this is going to bring to the Mortal Kombat franchise. Although it looks like they're going in a very different direction because there's this new guy now, like Cole, you know, instead of Johnny Cage, they're gonna bring a new guy called Cole who no one knows. It's just so strange. Just bring fucking Johnny Cage. Like, it's just strange to me that you would just completely remove a character, an iconic character from a franchise and like substitute him with some generic character that you created. It's very strange to me. Even Liu Kang is taking a backseat to this. It's very strange. Liu Kang is essentially the protagonist of Mortal Kombat. Him, Johnny Cage, and Sonya Blade. I mean, the rest, you know, are, you know, supporting cast, but those three are the main three. And, you know, we're missing Johnny Cage. It seems like Liu Kang is not going to be playing like the most significant role in this. And it just seems like it's going to be centered around this Cole guy who, again, no one knows. I don't know if you can tell, but I'm super bummed out that there's no Johnny Cage. Like, that's like the one guy I always look forward to. It's like the cocky, like Hollywood star who's cocky, who's in a tournament, thinks he can beat everyone up. You know what I mean? I want that guy. I want Johnny Cage. I want Johnny Cage to be in this movie. I want the guy that told Goro to his face that those were $500 sunglasses, asshole, and proceeded to make mashed potato of his nuts and threw him off a cliff. That's the guy I want. That's the guy that we all want to see on screen. By the way, these aren't $500 sunglasses. These are just the only ones I could find in the house. I know they look lame, but they did the job, all right. Anyhow, so we have this Cole guy, and he just, you know, I read somewhere that this Cole guy, like in the early renditions of the script, like when they were still busy developing the story, apparently he's supposed to be, you know. And before I say this, I should just say that this might be a spoiler. I think I don't know, because if it is true, then it is a spoiler, and I don't want to put you through that. So if you want to skip ahead a bit, that's fine. But apparently this Cole guy turns out to be Scorpion because he's got like a tattoo, a birthmark. He's got a tattoo of the Mortal Kombat symbol on his chest and so on. So I mean, he's like a special one or whatever. I really don't know what the situation is with this Cole guy. I have absolutely no clue. Because again, as far as I know, Liu Kang, dude, Liu Kang is the dragon. He's the fire and the dragon and the Shang Tsung killer and the Shao Kahn assassinator. Like he pretty much is the protagonist. So Sonya lays out the trailer for us, lays out the plot line for us. She tells this Cole guy that, you know, there's a tournament, and she thinks that they're invited. She says she heard about it first in a mission in Brazil where Jax lost his arms at the hands of Sub-Zero. Again, with that, I don't remember Sub-Zero taking Jax's arms. I remember it being Goro taking Jax's arms. So it's just, I don't know the lore really, but as far as I remember, it was Goro that took Jax's arms. But anyhow, it looks like it's gonna be all right, man. It looks like it's gonna be okay. Like I said, it looks B grade-ish, but I'm super excited. Super bummed out about that Johnny Cage thing though. I just can't, like, it's like the only thing I want to talk about in this video. Like I don't know. I Shadow Kick, you know, like I don't know. The good thing, though, is that it's R-rated. Like, the biggest bummer from back in the day, like with the first Mortal Kombat movie that came out in the early 90s or mid 90s, I think, I'm not really sure, was that it was PG-13, so no fatalities. So they made a film. Well, first they made a game, a very violent game that the kids loved, and then they made a film for the kids that loved that game for the violence, and took away all the violence. It's weird. It's like a weird trick that they played on the kids. But yes, so this is all the way R-rated. You see Mortal Kombat in all its glory in this trailer, man. Like, it's just blood on blood on blood. Speaking of R-rated, there's a cool scene with Kano holding a heart, and he's like, "You fucking beauty." And I remember that shit, dude. Like, I remember from, like, back in the day, in the very, very first Mortal Kombat video game, one of Kano's fatalities was ripping your heart out and, like, holding it while it's beating. So that's pretty cool. Towards the end of the trailer, Shang Tsung, like, says, "Finish them." And then the trailer just goes into a montage of just, like, fatality after fatality, which was really cool. Like, I really enjoyed that. Like, I think we need some R-ratedness in Mortal Kombat. It's what Mortal Kombat is anyway. So we see Scorpion fighting Sub-Zero, which is something people have wanted to see for decades. Because back in the day, man, kids wanted to see Sub-Zero. They wanted to see who's better, Sub-Zero or Scorpion. I mean, we saw some of it in Mortal Kombat Annihilation, but I don't think that counts. I don't think we don't talk about that movie. But anyhow, it looks like a sweet ass fight, man. It looks really, really good. There's a scene where Sub-Zero, like, slices Scorpion's arm, and like, blood splats out into the air, and he freezes the blood and stabs him with his own blood. That's what I call combat creativity, my friends. So the Mortal Kombat trailer, what do you guys think? You guys think it's going to be good? What do you think of this new Cole guy? What's your take on the Johnny Cage not being there of it all? Please let me know in the comments. Like, subscribe, it will really help out the channel, and I will see you on the next review.